Hello friends, here we are with the next edition of Skill Times from NSN, the skilling industry fortnightly newsletter. And as you can see in this edition, there's a bit of festivity that we tried to convey because Diwali is fast approaching, and we thought, why not create awareness about people who make this festival so special for us. So we have a story on the formal sector, which is the Handloom House in Hyderabad, and there is another organization called Cheneta Bhavan, which is completely dedicated to handlooms. And we spoke to people here, understood how handloom industry is catching up with technology and times, and also how they are training their people in the latest designs and so on. So this might really interest you to know more. Not only the formal sector, we also tried to go on the streets, meet the informal sector vendors like the flower sellers, the diya sellers, who bring so much of vibrancy and beauty to this festival. And as you can see here, we try to understand what their problems are and how the seasonal business affects them, and you know, positively, or what are the issues they are facing generally in their business. So this is another story which is especially done on the occasion of Diwali. Now coming to the other interviews which we regularly feature. This time, as you can see, we have Whistling Woods International. We spoke to Mr. Chaitanya Chinchlikar, who is the Vice President of Whistling Woods International. Then you see here Mr. Sanjeev Raut from C.V. Raman College of Engineering. I'm sure you're all familiar with this now, because Ashwath Narayana, who's won the gold medal in World Skills Competition, is from this college, and this college has been doing exceedingly well to train students in skills and education, both in the engineering streams. So let's quickly look at what they had to say. Here, as you can see, the Whistling Woods story is mostly talking about how Mr. Ghai's vision, Mr. Subhash Ghai's vision to set up an institute like this is showing results now by bringing the academia and the industry together, and the kind of courses they offer, and how they want to bring in a change in the lives of youth by saying, do what you love to do and don't get influenced by everybody else. So I think this is a wonderful message coming from them. And Mr. Raut had wonderful things to say, and I think most of them are very exemplary. Particularly what caught attention was the center of excellence that they have established in their college, and how they train people, and how they are trying to make many skill-based jobs aspirational, like for example plumbing and so on, by bringing the design element into these job roles. Then we have these ladies here. One of them is Nidhi Pundir from HCL Foundation. And she's given us the complete story on how HCL Foundation is the CSR arm of HCL Technologies, and it's making a lot of difference in the lives of children and youth through many initiatives in skills and vocational training. And they also fund many organizations as a part of their foundation. So this is something I think you can go detailed into and understand their initiatives, and contact them if required for any information. Then we have this very interesting story about Hema Balakrishnan, who happens to be from Hyderabad, and she is one of the inspiring ladies, a social entrepreneur who's done wonderfully well in coming up with many creative ideas to promote artisans who work with terracotta. So she started with earrings, jewelry, etc., but today she has a whole range of products which they sell out of many outlets and also online. So this is the story of Color the Earth, and I'm sure this is going to inspire you as well. So please go through this. And then we have our articles from our content partners. One of them is Certified, and as they have been regularly writing and educating us about the role of blockchain and how their blockchain platform is transforming the certification and skills and education. In fact, you are invited to log into their platform and understand how it works. So please check out the details here and then try to log in and explore it yourself. Then comes the industry integrated training, which is being offered by BridgeNow Academy, which is a P3 initiative. So as you can see here, the training is for the aerospace sector, and they have come up with very relevant industry integrated programs, which are for structural design, structural analysis, and aerospace technical publications. So if you wish to know more, please write to them, and they would be happy to tell you what these courses are and how it would prepare you to get employed in the aerospace sector. This is about the stories we have featured, and next comes the most interesting event in the next month, which is the National Abilympics happening in Delhi. This is from Sarthak and NAAI. It's also a conference on disability, so please check out the details in case you are interested to attend the event. And I'm very delighted to tell you that we have just started our employability skills or future skills video series. So this is the first video, which is on adaptability skills. Do visit our YouTube channel, subscribe to our channel, and follow us for regular videos on most of the future skills that we'll be publishing every week. And then, of course, this is the news and events section, and this time, as you can see, we were inundated with so many updates, and here we feature a few updates, which is a interesting move from Schaeffler India, which has just launched an training center, which is a mobile training center for automotive aftermarket. So please go through the details. It might interest you to get in touch with them. And recently there was a roundtable in Delhi hosted by Quest Alliance on women ITI ecosystem, and the deliberations here are reported in this article, so it may interest you to go through it as well. And one more important news here is the request for proposal, which is from the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. They are inviting proposals from consultants who would be interested in evaluating 6 skill development schemes. So as you can see, there are few more updates. Please spend some time, and I hope you find our stories interesting and relevant. If you have any feedback to share, do let us know, and I hope our efforts in creating awareness about skills and bringing skills and education together, we are taking small steps, baby steps each time, and I really hope this is adding on to the larger ecosystem in India, which is still evolving. So thank you so much for spending your time. A very happy Diwali to you, your family, and friends. Enjoy and have a great time. So we will catch up soon during the next edition of the newsletter. Wait for us, and in the meantime, please go through all the stories whenever you have time, and do share them in your network. Thanks a lot. Goodbye. Have a nice day.